BlackBerry's finally decided if you can't beat them, join them. So yeah, this is the Android running BlackBerry DTEK50. It's not BlackBerry's first Android phone. That was the BlackBerry Priv, which came out last year, but you still had a slidey physical keyboard on that one. This one, the DTEK50, catchy name, eh? This doesn't have a keyboard. It's the fully touchscreen Android phone, and it's the first that BlackBerry's done. It's mid-range in specs and in price. It costs £275 direct from BlackBerry at the moment. It has 3 GB of RAM on board, and it ships with 16 GB storage. But you've got some nice things here hidden in the tray: a micro SD card reader for up to 256 GB, and it's powered by a Snapdragon 617 processor, so firmly in mid-range compared to some of this year's flagships. The design is quite normal, black. You've got metallic-ish edges, headphone jack, micro USB, and a sort of crosshatch rubberized pattern on the back, which we didn't really like at first, but actually stops it slipping around, and it's quite nice. And you've got the BlackBerry logo there, but it's the most un-BlackBerry looking BlackBerry we've seen, really. It ships with Android Marshmallow 6.0.1. And then yeah, DTEK, what does it mean? Well, it's an app that was originally seen on the Priv, but this is actually now named after DTEK, which we think is a play on the word detection. So BlackBerry is saying that this is the most secure Android phone on the market. That's a slightly dubious claim in our opinion. It more makes you aware of how secure you've set your phone up. So it's not really doing anything specifically different apart from how it encrypts BBM, which is BlackBerry Messenger, but no one really uses that anymore. So here you can see that I've purposefully not done a screen lock to show you that that's bad, you should do that. Your data is encrypted, but see, you haven't set a screen lock, and so it just takes you through how to improve the security on your phone. It's more of a coaching system than any specific new software as far as we can see. What we do like about it, it is kind of good because it doesn't feel like a BlackBerry. It's pretty much stock Android. The app tray is exactly what you'd expect. The touchscreen's quite nice, a little bit of a better definition than we would have thought. And BlackBerry Hub is really useful. It basically stores all of your different apps and notifications in one place. You can go via app, or you can just see a big old list of everything there. It's kind of like having all your emails in one place, but it's for every app, and that's pretty cool. The other thing which is slightly confusing is it has a key on the side, which it calls a convenience key. We just use it to set up the camera, which launches nice and slow, as you see there. Now, there you go. But you could assign anything to that, really. The problem here is it's £275, but for £50 more, you could get a OnePlus 3, which has flagship pretensions. It's not a bad price, but we just don't know who's going to buy it. So yeah, check out the full review, but this is the BlackBerry DTEK50.